Hey everyone, it's Darren. Welcome. Today we're going to be talking about converting between numbers and text. Data in Excel inherently is always either numbers or text. And the numbers and text can be formatted different ways, so it looks like there's a lot of different formats, but usually it's one or the other is what it really comes down to. And to switch between them, you just change the formatting. If you are trying to do calculations on numbers and the numbers are text, sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. So every now and then you will actually have to change things. So we're going to talk about how to do that. So on the screen here, I have some numbers, and you can see that these are numbers because these are right justified. And down below it, I have text, which is left justified. And if you don't change the justification on your data, this is the default. Numbers will always be right justified, text will always be left justified. And up here we have the functions that you can use to go from numbers to text. We'll start with numbers to text. Okay, so first one is the car function here. A2. And that gives you something completely unexpected. This is something people run into. What this is the ASCII character 2. So if we copy this down, that's a space, that's ASCII character 32. And those ones give errors because ASCII only goes up to 255. And just for completeness here, if we run this down here, you get the same thing because the car function. If it's text, it'll just convert it for you. And that's pretty common in Excel. What you'll see as you're working is Excel actually converts them automatically most of the time, unless you're either doing weird formatting to start with, or you need to put in weird formatting for some reason. And you're allowed to do both. So what about code? Code's another one out there. If you bring up the text, function wizard, you'll see code. So code of A2, 49. So one gives you 49. Well, why does one give you 49? Because the character one in ASCII has a value of 49. And if we keep going down here, character of three is 51, five is 50, or sorry, yeah, five is 53. These are usually not useful unless you're programming or outputting specific data. If you have to do it, it's there. It works great. Okay, so the function that people are mostly looking for when they're trying to convert into text is the text function. And the text function has a lot of options to it. In its most basic form, it's text. A2, and then a string. In this case, I just went straight numbers. So I just put some numbers in there. And if we take this down, you see this actually converts all of them okay. But when you get down to here, you see something's wrong here. 32.1 went to 32, it dropped off the decimals. So if you want to keep the decimals, then you have to put in a dot with your number of decimals. And that only gives us one decimal. Well, how if you want more decimals? Well, put in more. So we'll put in 1 lot of decimals. And it doesn't. It only gives you the number that you actually have if you're using the pound sign. It does always put a decimal point on it. Whether you want the decimal point there or not, you'll always get a decimal point. So depending on what you're doing, you might need to strip that off with editing functions. If you check out the link in the description, I have the functions for left, right, len, all those, and that will tell you how to strip that off. But you see here, I have another column, the easy way. This is what you'll normally be doing when you're trying to convert from a number to a text string. And what that is you'll just use it. So let's say I wanted to do equals A1 and A2. And the ampersand there is just a concatenator. It sticks two strings together. So now it gives you number one, and number one is a string. So it just converts automatically. And usually Excel will convert them automatically. If you're doing something that needs a number, it'll usually make it a number. If you're doing something that outputs a string, it'll usually convert it to a string for you. Okay, so let's look at the other option here, which is the other direction. What if we're going from text to a number? Okay, so there's an easy way we'll get to, but there's two functions that are going to be useful here. The main one you'll use is value. And there's value A2. And you see here, the top ones I have are text. And you can tell because they're left justified. And the bottom ones are numbers. And you can tell because they're right justified. So if we go ahead and copy this down to all of them, we see that it just converted if it needed to, and didn't convert if it didn't need to. The output of value is always a number. So it gave us a number, even if, like in the case of these ones down here, there was a number at the beginning. Now you might wonder why I put this thing in here. And nobody formats numbers that way, right? Well, unfortunately, sometimes you do get numbers like that. It can happen for a variety of different reasons. Sometimes you can't use a dollar sign, for example, but you want to represent dollar signs. Sometimes you can't use a decimal point because decimal's a specific reserved character for some reason, or commas. So here we have 1,234,567.89, except it doesn't look like that. Well, number value lets you fix that. So let's take a look at how number value works. Number value, and you'll see those last two parameters are optional. So if we're just using regular numbers, we don't need the last two parameters, so we'll just do A2. And then we'll copy this down. Great, everything was perfect, except we didn't fix those two. So what do we do for number value? Well, let's come up here and hit the function wizard. And you see the first parameter is the decimal separator. And the decimal separator is between the whole number part and the decimal part. So decimal separator in this one is the at sign. And you have to put that inside of quotes. What about the group separator? Well, the group separator, as we normally use it in the US and Canada, is a comma. So let's go ahead and put in the comma there, but the value here that we're using is actually the asterisk for that. And as you know, if you've used the function wizard before, you get previews. So it shows you right here what your preview is going to be. And this gives us our number, exactly what we wanted. And if we actually copy this down onto the one that was a number value, it fixes that number for us also. So if you get numbers that are in a weird format, this is what you need to do to straighten them out, is you have to just use the number value. Now, you'll notice I have another column here, the easy way. And from the first part, I'm sure you've already figured out what it is, which is that you just do it. You can do, so here we have these two numbers. These are both text. If we want to just do basic math on them, so we'll equal A1, A2 plus A3. And it adds them together. It knows to convert those. If, on the other hand, we had done equals A2 ampersand A3, it would concatenate them. So the mathematical operator is the plus, minus, times, whatever. It knows that the output of that is a number, so it assumes your inputs are numbers and converts if needed. The ampersand, it knows that the output is a text string, so it'll convert to text strings automatically. So unless you have weird formatting like this over here, or any other odd things going on, usually you can just use value. Sometimes you will need to use these if you are doing certain conditional tests, you stick them into ifs or whatever. Occasionally you'll actually have to do the actual conversion manually. In most cases, you can just let it convert and it will. In other cases, you have to convert. Also, if you are sending data out to another system, that's another case where often you'll actually be forced to convert it, because when Excel outputs your data, it will output a string inside of quotes, typically. It will output a number without the quotes, typically. And if some other computer program is receiving that data, it will interpret it very differently, and chances are it won't do the conversion. So you may have to convert. If you have to, now you know how. And I have some other videos on formatting text, formatting numbers. You can check those out. Those are linked down in the description. If you need to either read in odd formats, write out odd formats, whatever you have to do, there are ways to do that. There are ways to do it real time. There are ways to do it with functions. So, hope you learned something from this video. I hope it was useful to you. If you learned anything, if you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit notify so you can see when I release new videos. And we have a Patreon page at patreon.com/dataanalysisexcellence that would really help out the channel a lot if you could help us out there. And have a great day.